by God. He was offended that God is helping somebody. And he began to even express his disappointment and concern. He said, "Why are you healing this woman on the Sabbath? Are there not 6 days that the law says you should work? And on the seventh day, you shouldn't do any work like healing this woman?" Jesus answered him and said, "My friend, let's face it. This morning before you get to the synagogue, or after this gathering, you are going to lose your donkeys, your cows, your dogs, your cats. You are worried about the fact that they are thirsty. And I shouldn't worry about this that I died for. I should leave them bound. You are losing dogs and cats and cows." Said, "This daughter of Abraham ought also to be healed and to be loosed." The Bible says, after he responded, I'm going to preach it. After he responded, there was shame that came upon his adversaries. You know, you can have adversaries in the church. Opposers of vision and ministry. I'll preach it another time, that one. Today I'm not preaching. I'm preaching my time for freedom has come. Amen. Says, after Jesus addressed him, the people rejoiced and blessed the Lord and glorified the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Now, I want us to look at this story because it speaks about you and me. Because I was very blessed, you know, sometimes when you are studying and when you come to preach, it's not the same. Because when you are studying and you are listening to God, he speaks volumes to you. And sometimes you try to articulate the volumes that you heard and you run short. Because when God speaks, it's not the same when man speaks. Yeah, but when I was reading this particular text, the first thing that came on my mind and in my heart is that God is concerned about me. Yeah, I was so moved that God cares. He cares about me. God is personal. God is personal. We might be here in a crowd, in a group of so many people, and but God is busy looking through the crowd to see who is bent. How are they bent? For how long have they been bent over? God is personal. And when he comes, even this morning, and looks in this crowd, we may not be bent in the physical like that woman, but God, who knows everything, who nothing is hidden before his eyes, he can see there are things represented here that are crooked. Yeah, God can see things that are binding us, different individuals here come to him this morning and they are bound in one area or another. But I want you to hear me today. He cares about what is binding you and what is troubling you, and he's very personal. He will call you by name and call you out and minister to you this morning. God is personal. You know, religion and tradition has made us to think that God is a strict man who is holding a rod waiting to punish us. That is not the Bible. That is from the pit of hell. God loves you. God is not looking for your wrongs. He's looking at how he can bless you and love you and save you and snatch you out of what is keeping you. Yes. I'm telling you something. In the crowd, do you know how big the church of Jesus was? But he was able to pick out one woman. Yeah, with her issue. And one of the other things I want you to know is that God has time for you. Yeah. He's not in a hurry. He can stop a service and call one woman and spend time to discuss an issue. And not only to discuss her issue, but to arrest her issue. Yeah. To arrest her issue. So God has time for you. Somebody said, God has time for me. You know, sometimes we think we serve a very busy God. No, we don't serve a very busy God. We serve a very big God. He's not busy for me. He's not busy to take time to listen to my prayer and to listen to the things that concerns me. He has time to pick one woman, stop the service, and deal with her problem and her situation. Tell the neighbor, we serve a good God who loves us. God loves you. God is concerned. I was reading a scripture yesterday. It says he is touched by the feelings of our infirmities. In other words, what I feel, he feels. What is troubling me, troubles him. What concerns me, concerns him. It says we have such a high priest in Jesus who is touched. You know what it means? It means that Jesus can feel it when I'm under oppression at work, or my husband is not treating me well, or there is sickness in my body, or people are abusing me and nobody understands. He understands. He is touched by the feelings of our infirmities. She was bent for 18 years. Listen to me. It doesn't matter how old your problem is. I want to prophesy to you that your time for freedom has come. When you come in contact with Jesus, everything that has been troubling you, it doesn't matter how long it has been going on, Jesus will arrest everything that concerns you, and it will walk out free from the situation. Somebody say, I hear.
Amen.
Yeah. And I want to show you something again. God, it's very important for you to see these things before we close the church and go home. Someone say, I want to see these things. Can you throw